gentlemen, welcome to the first, and I hope the only, episode of Velocity. Well, this could get a little bit better. Anyway, don't outside for your see how I am from 0 Curio and 0 Out. It's a pleasure to see you out here. Good to see you here. It's great to be here. Well, I haven't been in action in like almost like a week since that match was kind of made. But I have to ask you, what do you think Triple H succeeded in making this arena? I have no idea. I guess he wanted to expand the corporate ministry's hold on the WWE universe. Apparently, he has corporate ministry-fied, corporate He's turning the into the corporate ministry, right? That's what I was going to say. I was just keep checking on the words. Sorry about that. Fine. Okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you to Velocity, the first episode of Velocity here live. In Colorado Springs, Colorado, we have some new talent coming from across the globe. There he is, the game, the Cerebral Assassin, Triple H. Wow, mixed reactions in the crowd. In your dreams. Oh, here we go. Oh my god. Who's this? And this is Bradley Mann from El Salvador. This man from El Salvador weighing in at a whopping 350 pounds. This man is he's a bodybuilder. He served in two wars. He served in the Iraqi war about 2 years, and well, he's a big man. I can see that. Oh my god, that is a big individual. Oh my goodness. Look how tall he is! Yeah, 6 feet tall and weighing in at a whopping 326 pounds. Whew! Talk about power. Ugh, man, we'll see. We'll see what he can do. Well, here comes his opponent. And this is a man known as Mark Iavon, of course, is the grandson, of course, of his late father, his late WWE superstar father. Of course, this man was Ring of Honor for about 3 years, and so he left and decided to come to the WWE. And I'm guessing Mark says he's a very talented athlete. He said he's trained for this, and he can't wait to take down the NWO. He said he hates Shawn Michaels, doesn't like him. Says he one day wants to fight the man, Shawn Michaels, HBK, and hoping that someday he does get his chance. And of course on SmackDown, of course I gotta fight that monster Bradley. He just looked like a monster. Now, here we go. We got our first match of this corporate ministry show. And of course, oh my god, Bradley already on the attack. I don't know anything about that. And now, Sasuke, would you mind reiterating to everyone about Bradley Mann? Bradley Mann, of course, is from El Salvador. I mean, he's Spanish. He's part Spanish and part English. He's Spanish. His mother is Cuban, and his father is from Nigeria. And so, really not much to say about him in his file. He really didn't say much. He said his favorite wrestler as a kid was, of course, Andre the Giant, because he was so big. Yeah. And of course, he said his one goal is to destroy, seek and destroy any wood that gets in his way. And of course, it's a match. It's not a corporate ministry thing. Of course, Triple H has Cole Bradley. Oh my God! It's called Cole Bradley man. And a few weeks ago about his in-ring physique, and he was very impressed with what he did during the training. He was very impressed, and when he saw Mark Iovine, very cunning, very brash, has a smash mouth style, just likes to get inside your head, and I'm Bradley gonna counter, and Bradley man gonna counter. Of course, next Wednesday night, of course, we're gonna have another superstar coming over. Of course, we're gonna have Zach Mansley is a two-time AA champion. Oh my God, did you see that? Oh, that was a heart punch. Oh my gosh, that was a heart punch. I think he just punched him right in the heart. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Oh my God. Oh my God. Wow, did you see that? And Bradley has told me that he just loves to hurt people. That's his one goal in life, is to hurt people. And Mark, he admires the corporate ministry's tactics. He thinks their tactics are the most amazing. Another slam by Bradley. Just look at that Bradley man. You can tell he's a WWE superstar. Just by the way he's built. My goodness. Hey, Mark might have a few tricks ahead of him too. Bradley's not a small man. This man is a whopping 6 foot tall beast. Hang on a second. Look out. Oh! Oh my goodness! Oh! And Bradley is so used and so vicious. He just stopped that move in over like 3 minutes. Hang on, oh no, not another heart punch. Oh my God! Oh! Oh my goodness. Ow! Bradley, uh-oh. Oh, nice counter by Zep! Nice counter! Oh, he calls this? Oh! That's it. Bradley's done. And Bradley kicks out of one. Just watching these two just go at it. I'm just watching if Bradley just completely destroys Mark Iovine is he served in the U.S. Army for 5 years, ever since he was 20. This man is in his late 20s. He's about 27, and Bradley, he's almost 20. So you think about the age difference, it's pretty heavy. Another slam. I think he might actually stop his heart if you keep punching him there. Oh God! Ow. Bradley looks like Bradley is gonna get ready for that. Uh-oh. Choke slam! Oh my gosh! 2, 3, it's over! Bradley Man gets the victory! Oh boy. Yeah, have to fight that guy. Oh my gosh. Both. Very competitive. Very. Oh my gosh. I can't believe what we just saw. This 300 pound man just defeated Mark Iovine. He literally speaks Spanish, but he speaks a combination of both. So, and there's Swollen Kane. Yay. Oh, man. Well, he's lucky he's not going to fight him on SmackDown. Soul again is mad that he had to even do this.
Yeah, too.
Oh, dear God. I don't know if you want to see it right now. I don't think I want to right now. Yeah, really? You did a bad breakout. I was like, dang.
Yeah, I know, but like I said, not going to let something like this get me and get me down. I'm the World Heavyweight Champion. She's not, so whatever. Nobody cares.
Next!
Saga agreed to Stephanie's offer to join the Clipper industry, and of course, she's here tonight, so apparently she is.
Driver, who's her opponent?
I don't know. I have no idea. I'm guessing it's Kate Taiga because of the performance review she got, so it's sort of like her way of coming back. Of course, the Divas Championship has been vacated, so right now Stephanie is probably gonna personally announce the Divas Champion. Well, okay, yeah, she's gonna personally announce the Divas Champion, and I'm really hoping it's not Sakura, and I really hope it's not, because I would love to see Sakura just fail at just everything right now, because this is just like bullcrap to me, so whatever. She's like, wait, hold on, what? You want to see her fail? What? what? Okay. Wow, dude. I'm kind of surprised. I know. Anyway, let's move on. Oh, goodness. Anyway, these two are fighting. You want to see her fail? Oh my God! That was vicious. Dang. That's a little extreme, don't you think? I don't care. I was bawling like a baby earlier, but then I kind of realized, your parents don't even like me. So, what's the point of me getting back with her if my parents don't like me? What's the point of that?
Yeah, the point.
But let's move on with this match. Oh my God, right? Or like, after, yeah, that, oh God. I think that was the same leg that Maka injured 3 years ago in front of a steel chair. How was she able to do that? Like, she hit her like 3 times and her leg was just like, it just wasn't, there was no blood circulating in there, and I thought she was really gonna die. Well, she was gonna die. She was just like, had no circle. Oh my God! Oh. She just didn't have any circulation in her legs. I mean, her leg. Her left leg. That's why she always says her left leg kind of hurts when she walks. Didn't hurt when she came down the ring. She came down the rope. The ring. Oh.
Well, that's because.
Oh my God.
What?
Oh! Jeez. Jesus Christ. Hang on a second, what the deuce?
What the? Oh my God, submission! Oh,
ow! Oh dear. Oh dear.
Oh my God!
Ow. That'll ring your bell. Yeah, that'll round your brain for a few weeks.
Oh my gosh, you did that on AJ and it hurts.
AJ was out. Cold. Yeah, that was like, it was like a cold. Cold-blooded killer. What? You know what I mean? I'm just saying, like, what? Coldplay, what? Wait, hold on, what? Shut up. I'm just saying, like, you said Coldplay. I'm thinking, Cold-Blooded Killer? Oh! Oh! I was so close to saying, oh, shit. I know you were, and that's why I said, don't say it! And then I pulled another leg drop. Another leg drop by Miss Harno. So kind of twitch. That was just one. Oh my god. Sasuke! What? That's what she is. Oh! What the deuce? Oh, ouch. Well, if Naruto is here, he'd probably say ow, her eye. Oh! And a triple decker. What? What? Triple what? Triple decker. Anyway, moving on. Uh-oh. Oh my god. Oh, my god. Damn, Kata. No, that hurt. And a little break. This match continues. Ain't gonna continue for long. Ain't gonna continue for long. This one, 3 minutes over. And the crowd goes wild.
Not really. Not really.
Not really. But this is called the last match of SmackDown logo. So anyway, Sakura gets the victory. Yay! I'm so happy I forgot to cheer. So apparently you're not. So okay, that's understandable. You know. But still, it's going to be fun as crap when we see it. And Sakura with an impressive victory over Kate Taiga. And after... What the? Hang on a second. What is that? I have no idea. Wait a minute. What the? Who is that? I have no idea. But... Oh, whoever she is. Oh! Hey, Kate! Oh! Wow. Whoever that is... Wow. That is incredible. Well, here we go. The main event of the evening. Here he comes. Gabriel. The atheist motherfucker. Why does he look like a Mexican guy? Like, he looks Mexican if you look at him. From a distance. See, it kind of does, it's funny. Even that, too, oh my god. But anyway, of course, Gabriel competing in his first match ever since his long absence. I think it was due to an injury. Because, well, it wasn't something else. He had a baby. Him and Milo were having a baby. Oh boy. Big Daddy Cool coming down the aisle. What's Diesel doing here?
I guess Triple H tipped him. I mean, this is his best friend.
Oh my god. Oh, I'm broke out. Diesel. This is crazy. Diesel is in. Is here. Oh my goodness. This guy weighs a whopping. There's the pounds. 200 pounds. Woo! Daddy Cool.
I love it. Big Daddy Cool, yes. Big Daddy Cool, Kevin Nash. Oh, Diesel.
Oh my god.
Here we go. That guy that weighs almost 300 pounds. And...
Oh!
Yeah. It's not easy picking up that.
Oh, please. You fought Rito before, and please, he weighed almost more than you. That's true, but still, he was very big. Very big, had a big ass to him. Oh! Ow. Yeah. You gotta say, ooh. I thought these. Oof! I figured like Gabriel was gonna fight Kevin tonight, but apparently those two are gonna wait until over the limit. The fight for custody of Yuri and the courtesy of Mary Renee. Didn't they do that last year? Yes, but it wasn't to this extreme that they would do it. Oh! And a neckbreaker by Diesel. You know, I always imagine Diesel as this big guy. I could just hurt you. Anyone feel any regret for it? No, apparently he's not feeling regret now because we're Gabriel. Trying to get a breather away from Diesel. Away from Big Daddy Cool. And Big Daddy Cool will always stay out, but in 3 minutes, he will knock you down like a house of cards. This Gabriel has not been in the ring since 2012. And that spirited rivalry with Jeff and Moderate, and we haven't seen him in about 3 years. Ever since 2013, when I burned his face. Or when you burned his mask. You set his mask on fire.
Oh yeah, I did.
Oh man, that was funny. That was so cool. That was so cool, and then it was... Oh! Diesel just went down!
I've never seen a man go down that hard on a punch.
Well, you know, Gabriel is very fond of his fast strikes. And his quickness. He has like the quickness of a snake. He has the quickness on a bear. Oh, excuse me, a snail. Okay, he hits the ground. This is gonna be a very heated match between these two. Which is our main event of the evening, but still. Very frightening, Diesel. Why? Because I don't know if Gabriel's gonna hurt him. Oh my gosh. Oh! Are you kidding me? Oh! That man is 7 feet tall! Almost my height!
6 feet?
Yes, yeah, six! No, I'm like 5 feet 11, I think. 5 feet 9, if you think about it. Hang on. Wait a minute, what the? What the?
Oh my god! Oh!
What was that?
I have no idea.
But it hurt. That's all that matters. It hurt. That's all that matters. Dad, it hurt.
Again, Diesel. Oh. Of course, Gabriel and Kevin are going to be in a ladder match, so apparently pinfalls and submissions do not count. I mean, Kevin can tap out as many times as he wants, but it's not going to change the course of the match. Because the only way any of them are going to win is if they climb that ladder and reach for that briefcase. In that briefcase is custody of UA. It's going to be hanging above the ring. And when it hangs above the ring, you better be ready for a fight. Because those two are going to fight like it's nobody's business.
Oh!
Another high-risk move.
They're
trying his best to keep Diesel at bay. So far, Diesel has not been successful in trying to stop this man, Gabriel. God, not again. I guess Gabriel is insane. People would say he has the strength of a bull. Actually, two bulls and a rhino.
That's a lot of strength.
That is a lot of strength. Two bulls and a rhino? Wow. Hang on a second. Hang on. Whatever I'm with, it hurt like a bitch.
Diesel's like, oh.
3 and it's over.
I know
he's gonna win.
It was new, but... Call that move the priest knocker.
Priest knocker.
Priest knocker? Really? Well, thanks for watching Velocity. See you on SmackDown.